Wait. Before we start,
let me introduce myself properly first. My name is Katya.
Katya? Oh, Lord, Katya. Never flirted with one, never proposed to one, never even married one.
In real life, I am a vision mixer, a video editor, and I started my own television production company for about, I think, 8 years ago. I'm in the midst of raising a few kids, and I do that together with a lovely guy I usually call Sound God.
Greetings, Sound God.
Greetings.
Okay, I do have obnoxious moods now and then. So what? Who doesn't? To the point, I don't want to telephone now, but since I got involved with streaming video more and more, a mutual interest called video connected me to my first day. Who's calling me?
I normally start my show with a nice intro done by Katja Treiber.
And he asked me to learn and test BitBlaster from scratch. And now I am asking you, although you don't know me, to join and support me on this adventurous journey. Help me out, guys. Come on.
Remember her now? No such luck.
To Mike Versteeg, who is the godfather of BitBlaster. He created and developed it. Still developing, actually. I think he'll never stop developing. I think he has a Mac in his place. All right. Let's see if Mike's home. And here he is, Mike himself. Mike actually doesn't want to be bothered too much. He's the kind of guy who just wants to program.
Dat gaat ze natuurlijk.
So, what is BitBlaster actually? Well, it's the state-of-the-art TV production, broadcast, recording and streaming software. The BitBlaster layout is made of various modules. The modules are user-definable and can be added, deleted or placed anywhere you want in the interface. This is how you add a module. A module can be a camera, can be audio, player, video overlay, video effect, preview, program, recorder, streamer and, of course, the video switcher. In the module window itself, you can choose your input, video standard, transitions, and more. The player offers many useful features. You can play various media types. And that means we can go to commercial break at any time.
When you're in a gym, you're like an eagle, king of the sky.
Remember, Jim, no playing with the switches, please. Sorry.
So, of course, I asked Mike for a little demonstration of this beautiful program. What we did was we set up a few cameras. And it doesn't even matter what kind of camera, because you can hook up almost anything to BitBlaster. Like this consumer camera, HDV. We set up for about 3 of these cameras. And there's also another great feature about BitBlaster. You can even use Skype. So, yeah, that's my Mac. I made a Skype connection with Mike. Here you go. And Mike captures my source. This awesome shot.
Yeah?
Yep, I'm ready, Mike. Let's do it. But the big question, of course, is, will BitBlaster, which is available at a relatively low entry price, work just as good as the professional stuff I'm used to work with in studios? And when I've installed BitBlaster myself, maybe in the future I can provide you with a more exciting testing environment. On the other hand,
it's just a way of testing my software.
If you want to know about the differences between the BitBlaster software, visit bitblaster.com. And while you're at it, there's also a great forum where BitBlaster users share their learnings and tips. Good chance you can find Mike there as well. See you, dude! There is one thing I'm very worried about, though. VidBlaster is a Windows-only application.
Hello, I'm a Mac.
And I'm a PC. We've got a little network going here, and it was very easy to set up.
We speak each other's language.
Hope you will join me next time where I'm installing Windows on my Mac.